Hello, in this video we are going to investigate GPU-based Hall generators. The main advantage of GPU-based Hall generators is the improved performance over CPU-based visualizations. GPU-based Hall generators also use your graphics card in order to compute the visualization. This also means that your target device must be able to use compute shaders. Older devices and mobile phones of special kinds may not be able to do that. Also, if you are developing for a console, check out the specification of your console if it states that it can use compute shaders. If your target device does not use and support compute shaders, then you also have to still continue to use the existing ones which are only running on the CPU. Additionally, in this video we also investigate how to use tree-planar mapping, because tree-planar mapping is very important for GPU based Hall generators. Therefore, we have here a sample scene which has three voxel blocks. The left one uses a CPU-based Hall generator, the middle and the right one use GPU-based Hall generators. Now let's take a closer look to the CPU-based Hall generator here. And we can see here that this voxel block here uses the normal traditional margin cubes underscore multi-texture Hall generator. Here we can see the parameters. It uses the default obsidian material, and also we have here a new setting. The main difference between the CPU and the GPU based Hall generator is the calculation of the UV coordinates and normal coordinates. Here the CPU one calculates the UV and normal coordinates after the mesh has been generated by using the mesh itself as source. The GPU-based one derives the normal and UV coordinates from the voxel data directly. So here, let's check out the difference. If you use this asset for some time, you may notice those lines here. These are the lines between the individual cells, and here we can see here some little error here, because the normals do not transition perfectly between cells, because each cell is calculated individually. So if I set this now to true, it will regenerate, and we can see here now that those lines are gone. Also, we can see here now errors which are generated because those normals point into a direction where no useful UV coordinate can be derived. In order to get rid of those lines, we have now switched to tree-planar mapping. Also, tree-planar mapping is included inside the package now. And here we have a sample material called Obsidian Tree-Planar. We are going to select and assign it here. And now when we build the mesh, we can see here now that it is a little bit too bright. So we have to lower the UV power here a little bit. Like this. And now we can see here that the material has no artifacts, no errors, and it has a smooth transition regardless the direction of those individual cells. Because tree-planar mapping does not require UV coordinates anymore. Also, another advantage of tree-planar mapping is the ability to implement perfect tessellation. Here I have now activated tessellation And also this tessellation is way too strong, so we have to lower the power here. We have to reduce it and make it very, very small. Like this. And now when we take a closer look, we can see now that we see no cracks and no holes inside the tessellation. I think we can reduce it more. We have very, very small values here. Come on. Minus 0.5, and here we add this a little bit. 3, like this. And here we can play around with the tessellation. And you can see we have, I mean, you can also use this value again in order to prevent the borders, to get better borders. So I highly recommend to still use these parameters, but now you can also disable this here in order, and you can see here now how the tessellation is working. But now we are going to turn it off, as tessellation is very expensive to the GPU, but if you can afford it, you can also, I mean, you can lower the tessellation. And it is very, very nice, especially if you are closer, if you run around on the surface, then you can see here the tessellation. And you can see here the terrain is very, very rough, so the value here is indeed way, way too high. But this now is a better value here. And you do not have those. Now, we can see here, this border here, this corner here, how it transits smooth around the corner. And this is very, very nice. And also, especially this one, this triangle here is the corner of the wall block here, and it also has to traverse around this corner here without creating cracks or seams. And the old one requires barycentric coordinates, and this one does not require that anymore. So this is now tree planar mapping. And you can see the advantage is that this one is way, way, way superior towards the normal mapping using UV coordinates, especially when using procedural and voxel-based geometry. And now let's take a look to the GPU-based hull generator. Here we have a GPU-based hull generator. This hull generator here uses your graphics device in order to compute the visualization. And also we can see here the old obsidian material. This is not triplanar mapping. This uses the normal obsidian mapping material, which was used here. And in order to see that, we have the option to generate cube UV coordinates. And we can see here the old pattern, and we can also see those lines here. Just for reference, so you know that this one requires triplanar mapping. And here, to the right one, we have now version 2. This version is better than version 1, otherwise this would not be version 2. So here we have the fastest one actually now. This one is faster than this one. And also, this one also has level of detail functionality. And now let's play around a little bit. First, this material here uses the tree planar material. I can increase the rebar here now, and we can see here this material slowly melting. And let's keep it like this here. And when I take a closer look now, yeah, here is it. We can see that those parameters here are almost identical to the CPU-based one. Actually, it's the same algorithm, it's margin cubes, so there is not much difference. Here you have those settings to simulate the CPU-based UV and normal calculations. However, keep in mind, those settings are very, very expensive, so I recommend to keep them disabled and use a triplanar shader. Here we have the normal texture channels. Here we have the margin cubes. You have to keep this assigned. It has to use the V2 one. And also you have here the target LOD, which is derived from the voxel generator itself. Now let's do a little performance comparison. Therefore, I'm going to delete the version 1 here. And now let's take Bosua here. We have here now CPU based on the left side and GPU based on the right side. Also, we are going to keep in mind that we have the same values here, 8 times 8 times 16. We also set it here, 8 times 8 times 16. And now let's kill that and kill that. And now load this one. And now we are loading this one. And now let's investigate which one is faster. Since they both are building up the visualization very, very fast, we have now to change the rules a little bit. So on the left side, we set this to 32. So we want that this is generated instant. And we increase this to 16. Well, like this, 32. Now we have to now check those rules. Also, we have to disable collision. We do not want that the Unity collision baking system is reducing the has a performance impact, because we know that the collision baking is probably the most expensive thing, which is independent on the Hull generator used. And also here 32 to 32, and here we also do the same, 32 to 32, no collision. And now when we rebuild, we can see here now that actually the cube is rebuilding. We don't see it, but we can see what's going on here. And I can also do here this now. And now let's start the profiler. In order to start the profiler, I'm going to select window. Then I go to analysis. I select profile. And I can also profile the editor. Can select this here now, and we can see here the performance graph here. And now we simply hit the rebuild button. We have now fast. We can see here the performance spikes here now coming. I have to stop it now very, very, very fast. Now I have stopped it. Now let's select this one here. And we can see here that We have 309 milliseconds, 322, 349. So we have about, at least we have 300. And now we are going to do the same with the GPU-based one. Okay, I have to do this trick here. I have this trick here so I can stop it as very fast. And here we have 45. So 300 versus 45. So here we can see now that the GPU one is faster. So in this video, we have investigated tree planner mapping and the GPU-based hull generator. And I highly recommend if your device can use the GPU-based hull generator, then stick to the GPU-based one. And maybe if you have a modern and very, very expensive GPU and you are not using it to mine Ethereum or other cryptocurrency, which uses the very, very expensive proof of work algorithm, then you can also use your GPU in order to compute margin cube visualization for your voxel world. So see you later. Bye bye.